In previous video, we spoke about two Mesolithic and Neolithic cultures of old Europe, the Lepenski Vir and the Starčevo-Kereš-Kriš culture. We followed the progress of way of human life, which during the period of thousands of years developed from a small fishing village in Jerdap Gorge on the border between present-day Serbia and Romania. These cultures spread throughout Southeast Europe, mastering domestication of animals, production of agricultural goods, and workmanship of sophisticated and practical forms of houses, pottery, tools, figurines, etc. As we saw, around 4400 BC, in its last phase, the Starčevo culture was slowly replaced with a new one, which will cover similar area and have similar or at least related forms of ceramics, figurines, and housemaking. Although there are another theories in archaeology, for example, that the main contributor to developing this culture was a migration influx of the new people from southeastern regions of Balkans. There is no certain reason to reject the idea of continuity, at least cultural and technological, between Lepenski Vir, Starčevo and Vinča cultures. In world literature, the Vinča culture is also known as Turdaš-Vinča culture, named after two most significant sites of this culture, Turdaš in western part of Romania and Vinča, Belo Brdo, near Serbian capital of Belgrade. Beside Romania and Serbia, the Vinča culture covered the territory of western Bulgaria, eastern Bosnia and northern parts of North Macedonia. Other major sites include Belogradčik in Bulgaria, Drenovac, Pločnik and Rudna Glava in Serbia and Tartaria in Romania, which possibly hides the mystery of world's oldest writing, which we will discuss later during the video. All across mentioned territory there are numerous artifacts of standardized production as well as hundreds of settlements, out of which some can even be considered cities. In order to understand how important this is, I must say that officially the oldest world city is Eridu, a Sumerian settlement founded between 5 and 4000 years BC. Even if we stick to the modern definition of the city, which says that city is a settlement in which more than 50% of population does not engage with agriculture, we could still say safely claim that Vinča was the first or at least first European city. According to the archaeologist Dragan Janković, who has been personally exploring several sites of Vinča culture, there is a lot of archaeological evidence strongly indicating that significant percent of population, at least at Vinča, Belo Brdo archaeological site, have been performing craftsmanship and even trade, which is practically for other European cultures of that time considered impossible. Again, for the reference, the world's first long-distance trade officially is a trade of luxury materials such as spices, textiles and precious materials between Sumerians in Mesopotamia and Harappan civilization of the Indus Valley, taking place in year approximately 3000 BC. So, we might say that Vinča was the first or among the first cultures in the world to develop trade. This should not be strange considering the perfect geographical position of Vinča, which was located on the crossroad of all important routes in the region. Namely, in the vicinity of the site, there are several rivers out of which only larger ones being Danube, Sava, Morava and Tisa. Okay, wait, is good geographical position enough to prove the existence of trade? Well, of course not. There are archaeological evidences that show the exchange of goods between Vinča and other cultures from the region. One example is of course the obsidian. Obsidian is a volcanic glass produced when felsic lava extruded from a volcano cools rapidly. Obsidian was an extremely or vitally important resource in Neolithic, because it could be fractured to produce sharp blades, which were then used as heads for arrows in hunt, or blades for cutting grass and even haircut. The problem was, volcanic glass cannot be found at any place and especially not in Vinča, but only at several places in Europe, such as Greek island Melos, Sicilia and north part of Carpathian Mountains. It is confirmed though that obsidian found in Vinča is originally from the site at the north of Carpathians, and it is very likely that Vinča people took the advantage of its location and became first sort of trade and distribution center for the obsidian, where other South Balkan tribes could find and buy this material instead of going far north. In Vinča there have also been found shells and shell jewelry originally traded with the societies living at the Mediterranean coast. Also, the residents of Vinča produced an extremely valuable product of Neolithic, the painting colors. Red color, for example, was highly valuable product throughout the European continent and it was made from cinnabar, a mercury sulfide found on the local Mount of Avala. Samples of this exact color have been found on sites of other neighboring cultures. Also, there are examples of imports of salt from Tuzla in present-day Bosnia and Herzegovina, all indicating well-developed trade network. Let's now move on to how did the city of Vinča actually looked like. Well, just for comparison, before the time of the Vinča culture, people were living in a constant move, migrating from one place to another, in search for animals and other food. In that way, nobody had time to think about the living standard and the quality of habitation. After that, when farming began, people made the first long-lasting permanent settlements. But still, there was one issue remaining. That was the issue of utilization of farming lands, which after few years of intensive use eventually became infertile. The people of Vinča solved that big problem of Neolithic people by inventing the process of natural fertilization, which enabled them to live at one place permanently. That specific invention, at the first sight not that significant, have enabled tremendous changes in society, such as making possible living houses as we know them today, but also the occurrence of surplus of value, which later enabled trade and further development. This was the pathway that enabled the existence of cities. When speaking of cities, houses in Vinča were built systematically, in order and with same orientation, and all had communications or streets between. Houses were big, ranging from 20 to 80 square meters, with more than one internal division or room. All houses were built of wooden construction and then coated with a special mix of clay, sand, chaff and water in certain ratio, which was some sort of proto-mortar. On the surprise of archaeologists, almost all houses had ovens instead of fireplaces, which was very unusual for other European settlements of that time. A lot of archaeologists and historians are still confused with this level of living comfort and standardized construction found in Vinča. I would also add the fact that when the locality was discovered, archaeologists thought they had found a distant ancient Greek colony, while the dating would later show that Vinča is several thousand years older than the ancient Greece. What is interesting and also unlikely for other cultures, Vinča cities had no walls or any kinds of fortifications. Only in the youngest stages of this culture, which means sites built during the last 100 or 200 years of its existence, brings the findings of settlements built with walls, which were mostly located on hills. This indicates the beginnings of conflicts and wars, which was up to that moment unknown to the people of Vinča. Most likely, this was the result of the arrival of other new cultures. When speaking about organization and hierarchy, the society of Vinča was highly egalitarian one, with no signs of any social differences ever found. Even though there were surpluses of value, which is commonly linked with the occurrence of conflicts and wars in human society. Also, there are no artifacts of weapons and no other proofs indicating mass conflicts, wars or domination. Even the houses were all equal. Although there were examples of individual conflicts, systematic violence just did not happen, which is also unusual for all human societies even up to these days. If we take a look at the figurines, we can conclude these people were not celebrating a war or hunt gods, but rather a life, birth and fertility, all expressed through a motif of a mother. This was in fact a classical feature of all farming societies. If we talk about the art and the pottery of this culture, I would highlight two incredible forms of art. First are representative lids for vessels unique for Vinča culture, designed in the shape of a cat or owl-like face, with big almond eyes and very expressed ears. Although the meaning is not 100% certain, these lids possibly had the purpose of taking care of the stuff inside of the vessel. This indicates some basic norms of the Vinča society itself, i.e. being awake and taking care for the others. Second form of art, which I'm going to talk about, are the human or animal-like figurines, which represent the exceptional artistic reach of this culture. They come in different types and sizes, but all of them have the same big almond eyes, most likely indicating the cult of vigilance or being awake. Some of them have widespread arms, indicating the significance or a cult of hospitality. Tools used by the people of Vinča included blades, scrapers and knives made of obsidian, different kinds of stone axes, bone needles, hooks and many other. All of them were crafted in a beautiful manner and were amazingly precise. As an example, check out this perfect round hole made in the stone axe. I know, now you wonder, how did they manage to do that? Well, believe it or not, the answer is simple, but at the same time also genius. In fact, they were using only the bow, cane, stick and sand as abrasive. Cool, right? The nutrition of Vinča people was mostly based on domestic animals and their products, cereals, different kinds of mushrooms, legumes and other wild herbs, but also fish and even wild animals, even though they were not hunters. We could also say they had quite modern clothing, especially with their V-shaped shirts and even short skirts, which could be considered fashionable even today. Again, I know you ask, how do we know that? The answer is also very interesting. There are representations of clothes on Vinča figures and even the imprints left left on the pottery appeared as a result of placing the pottery on the textile while the clay was still fresh. This shows us the patterns and styles used on the textile. As you might guess, weaving was also a well-known method in Vinča, while clothes were of course made of flax. Even though there were other similar cultures throughout the European continent during 5th and 4th millennia BC, archaeologists agree that Vinča culture was far more technologically advanced than any other, even having the first confirmed examples of metallurgy and smelting of copper ore in Europe and possibly in the whole world. Serbian archaeologist Miljana Radivojević managed to prove that the Vinča locality of Belovode in eastern Serbia was the first known copper-making workshop in Europe. This shows that Vinča culture was familiar with advanced metal processing technologies, at least at the same time as Middle Eastern cultures. These astonishing findings were presented by an international team of experts in the field of archaeological sciences from the United Kingdom, Germany and Serbia at the 2008 World Congress of Archaeologists held in Vancouver, Canada. The only difference between Vinča culture and other later Copper Age cultures is the fact they were not using copper to make weapons, but rather only tools such as needles and different kinds of jewelry such as necklaces and earrings. The irony is the fact they were the pioneers of metallurgy and at the end they were most likely wiped out by other people who got the idea to use their findings to make weapons. Now, it is time for the most interesting part, literacy and writing. There were more than 1,000 of fragments of different kinds on a Vinča pottery, each containing kinds of inscriptions, which to a large degree reminds of letters. This left scientific public with huge enigma. The problem here is the fact scientists just can't agree on the real purpose of these symbols. Is it a writing system or simply a decoration? However, it is the fact no pottery has been found so far containing a complete text, except for the mentioned fragments with a few symbols. On the other hand, the fact is also that these symbols were inscripted after the pottery is made and not before, which might indicate that the intention wasn't to decorate the pottery, but rather to note or write down some information. What the information was, we just don't know, because without the whole text, it is impossible to decipher any language. Possibly, it might be the case that these people wanted to write down what is actually stored in the vessel, or in some other cases, these were internal signs of a family and had a purpose to mark the ownership upon the same object. However, some archaeologists noticed that certain number of identical symbols are constantly repeating all over the area of the Vinča culture, which means these symbols were actually standardized. This idea is still not widely accepted in official history, but I would dare to say, taking into account all previously said, that Vinča culture was actually a civilization that, if not gave the literacy to the world, then at least invented the first world's proto-writing, being only one step behind, which is, however, a big deal. Maybe the best-known example of Vinča writings are famous Tartarian tablets, i.e. three tablets discovered in Tartaria, Romania in 1961. The meaning of the symbols is of course unknown and their nature has been subject of much debate. Again, as a reference, the dating of these tablets far predates the Egyptian hieroglyphs and even earliest Sumerian script. Just think about that. Another important question is how did they bury their dead? Well, the answer is actually not yet known due to the fact that archaeologists didn't manage to find any graves except for a few individual cases. This is similar to the Starčevo-Kereš-Kriš culture as explained in the first part of the video. Only a few graves for hundreds of settlements of the Vinča culture is just not enough to make any conclusions, so the way of burial will still remain the enigma. Final question for today is how did this great civilization end? After many centuries of constant progress resulting with high technological achievements, the area covered by the Vinča people slowly lost its coherence and whole culture simply fell into decline. Most probable reason for this was the arrival of new cultures, possibly of Proto-Indo-European origin, who, according to famous Lithuanian-American archaeologist Maria Gimbutas, brought wars and violence, which was just not acceptable by the social norms of Vinča people. Wars and violence then resulted in other life changes, such as constant migrations, because in the war times it is impossible to maintain agriculture, live peacefully and keep high living standards. All that matters is staying alive. So, I would agree with Mr. Janković's thesis that actually the new system of values which could not be accepted by the Vinča people is responsible for the decline and finally disappearance. Some scholars support the idea that actual reason for the end of this civilization is its inability to adapt to new technological advances such as metal weapons, but I would say that civilization who invented the trade, metallurgy, proto-writing system and had society without any social divisions cannot be blamed for such a thing. It was all about the new system system of values which could not just be accepted by the people of Vinča. This is the system of values where it is acceptable to harm and kill other person instead of taking care for the others, where it is acceptable to steal others' resources by force instead of to work and produce by yourself, and finally the system of values which praises the war gods instead of a mother of life. Some would say this was a progress, I would say this was degradation. Who is correct, I don't know. In any case, thanks for watching this video, I hope you learned something new, and of course, if you like it, help it reach more people by clicking like, share and subscribe.